You are listening to Second Chance Ministry Radio. Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me at Second Chance Ministry Radio. My name is Frank S. Garcia. The following is entitled, In Christ I Am, God's Promises in Who You Are. Enjoy and have a glorious day.
Please note, scriptures are written in first person for personalization and application purposes. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. 1 Corinthians 5:7. Forward. Many people struggle through life with low self-esteem, feelings of failure, and/or convinced of worthlessness as a result of a past sinful lifestyle, abusive relationships, and/or hurtful and disappointing experiences. Jesus faithfully reaches out to us as Savior, Healer, Liberator, etc., and when we repent of our sinful state and make Him the Lord of our lives, we experience the miracle of being born again, and we become a new creation in Christ Jesus. Consequently, we enter the glorious realm of seeing old things passing away and all things becoming new, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Part of the newness is in coming to the realization that God sees us differently, Romans 12:2. So we are challenged through His Word to perceive ourselves likewise. This book, entitled In Christ I Am, will help you immensely in that regard. First conceived by Crystal Kuhn and Violet James as a series of Bible study notes for their personal use, it fast became a more comprehensive collection of truths that will change your thinking and lifestyle. Motivated by a desire to be a blessing to others, these anointed and godly sisters have willingly consented to share what the Lord has quickened to them by making this book available to you. It is my joy and honor to both endorse and recommend the reading of this book. I encourage you to eat and be satisfied, that the Lord thy God may bless thee in all the work of thine hand, which thou doest. Deuteronomy 14:29b. Pastor Leonard Gardner, Senior Pastor, Zion Christian Church. One special observation I made while reading your book is that it has a two-pronged approach to it. Not only does it give force and encouragement to what I feel is part of the picture of a person's persona, personality, self-esteem, your book gives a strong force and development to the most important part of a person's personality, character. You won't find this combination in a book very often. The one book in which these are always found is the Holy Bible, and yours follows it to the letter. I don't believe anyone who reads your book will argue against my observation. William S. Arnott, Ph.D. Introduction. Do you know who you are in Christ? If you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, He is residing in you by His Holy Spirit. You can identify with who the Scriptures say you are in Christ. You can personalize God's promises to you, put your name in them. God is speaking to you. By faith, you can receive all that God has for you. And as you yield to the working of the Holy Spirit in your life, you will be changed. The same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is in you. The only way to walk in His power is to know God, and the only way to know God is to know His Word. As we saturate ourselves in His Word and meditate on it, we learn of who God is and just what it means to be a child of God. God wants us to know who we are in Christ Jesus. Only then can we walk in all the provisions He's made for us. As a Christian, you don't ever have to be defeated in any area of your life. In Him, you are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer. There's nothing that you will ever face in this life that He hasn't already made provision for. As you meditate on who you are in Christ, you will find your mind being renewed, and your old ways of thinking will be replaced by the truth of God's Word. His Word has the power to transform your life. Once you truly understand who you are in Him, you will live the victorious, abundant life that Jesus died to give you. The following pages contain over 150 truths of who you are in Christ with corresponding scriptures. May the power of the living Word of God cleanse you, fill you, transform you, and set you free as you meditate on who you are in Christ Jesus. God bless you. Crystal and Violet. I am who God says I am. I have what God says I have, and I can do what God says I can do. For as the rain and snow come down from the heavens and return not there again, but water the earth and make it bring forth and sprout, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. It shall not return to me void, without producing any effect, useless, but it shall accomplish that which I please and purpose, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. Isaiah 55:10-11, Amplified. The following is a poem written by Crystal Kuhn. When I looked in the mirror. One day, as I looked in the mirror, I saw something I usually don't see. Something deeper, almost hidden. It was my very soul looking at me. Tell me, what do you see when you look at me? I heard from the depths of my soul. And why don't you always like the person you see? What is it that you believe about me? I pondered these questions and then realized many things I believed about myself might be lies. So I sought to find out what my father would say, and I asked him to help me see things his way. So he showed me someone very different and true, someone who looked more like him than I ever knew. Made in God's image, and so precious to Him, with beauty and purpose and His life within, I began to see clearly as God opened my eyes, and I started to change from the inside. Then I decided to look in the mirror once more, and this time I saw who Jesus died for. The lost and the sinner, the poor and the lame, the hurting, the angry, and all those in pain. I saw the beauty in those He loves, and in me, and how He can change a life for all eternity. I saw His great love, His goodness and mercy. I saw His amazing grace that abounds towards me. Now I see how much He wants me to know that I can be all that in Christ He says that I am. Preface. In Christ I Am can be used as part of a Bible study to empower the believer. On a daily or weekly basis, listen to the In Christ I Am audiobook. Study, meditate, and pray over all the confessions and scriptures. You may also want to journal your personal experiences and insight. This practice will not only help you understand your identity in Christ, it will strengthen your faith and deepen your walk with the Lord. Never stop reciting these teachings. You must think about them night and day so that you will faithfully do everything written in them. Only then will you prosper and succeed. Joshua 1:8. A. I am above only and not beneath. I am the head and not the tail. The Lord will make me the head, not the tail. If I pay attention to the commands of the Lord, my God, and carefully follow them, I will always be at the top, never at the bottom. Deuteronomy 28:13. I am above problems. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth. Psalm 121, 1 through 2. God raised me from death to life with Christ Jesus, and He has given me a place beside Christ in heaven. Ephesians 2:6. I set my mind and keep it set on what is above, the higher things, not on the things that are on the earth. Colossians 3:2. I am accepted. Jesus said, "Those the Father has given me will come to me, and I will never reject them." John 6:37. Everyone who calls on His name will be saved. Romans 10:13. He made me accepted in the Beloved. Ephesians 1:6. I am accountable. I am responsible. I make a careful exploration of who I am and the work I have been given, and then sink myself into that. I won't be impressed with myself. I won't compare myself with others. I must take responsibility for doing the creative best I can with my own life. Galatians 6, 4-5. I am anointed. I have an anointing from the Holy One, and I know all things. 1 John 2:20. The anointing I received from Him abides in me. Christ's anointing teaches me the truth on everything I need to know about myself and Him, uncontaminated by a single lie. 1 John 2:27. I am armed. See also, I am a prayer warrior. For though I live in the world, I do not wage war as the world does. The weapons I fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. I demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and I take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. 2 Corinthians 10, 3-5. I put on the full armor of God so that I can take my stand against the devil's schemes. For my struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, I put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, I may be able to stand my ground. And after I have done everything to stand, I stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around my waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with my feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, I take up the shield of faith with which I can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. I take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, I will be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Ephesians 6, 11-18. B. I am beautiful. What matters is not my outer appearance, the styling of my hair, the jewelry I wear, the cut of my clothes, but my inner disposition. I cultivate inner beauty, the gentle, gracious kind that God delights in. 1 Peter 3, 3-4. I am a believer. See also, I am saved. It's impossible to please God apart from faith. And why? Because anyone who wants to approach God must believe both that He exists and that He cares enough to respond to those who seek Him. Hebrews 11:6. If you can, said Jesus, everything is possible for one who believes. Mark 9:23. Jesus answered and said to them, "Have faith in God, for assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be removed and be cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Therefore I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. And whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses. Mark 11:23-24. I am blessed. See also, I am favored. Wherever I go and whatever I do, I will be blessed. Deuteronomy 28:6. The Lord blesses me, and with favor he surrounds me as with a shield. Psalm 5:12. I am blessed with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ. Ephesians 1:3. The Lord blesses me and protects me. The Lord smiles on me and is gracious to me. The Lord shows me his favor and gives me his peace. Numbers 6:24-26. I am bold. Jesus can sympathize with my weaknesses. He was tempted in all points, as I am, yet without sin. Therefore, I come boldly to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and grace to help me when I need it. Hebrews 4:15-16. Because of Christ and my faith in him, I can now come boldly and confidently into God's presence. Ephesians 3:12. The wicked run away when no one is chasing them, but the godly are as bold as lions. Proverbs 28:1. I am building my spiritual house. Jesus said, "Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock." Matthew 7:24. Paul said, "For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building. According to the grace of God which was given to me, as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another builds on it. But let each one take heed how he builds on it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Christ Jesus." 1 Corinthians 3:9-11. By wisdom a house is built, and through understanding it is established. Through knowledge its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. Proverbs 24:3-4. Unless the Lord builds the house, the builders labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the guards stand watch in vain. Psalm 127:1. See, I am called. He saved me and called me with a holy calling, not according to my works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to me in Christ Jesus before time began. 2 Timothy 1:9. I am carefree. I am anxious for nothing. Lord, when doubt fills my mind, when my heart is in turmoil, quiet me and give me renewed hope and cheer. Psalm 94:19. I cast the whole of my care, all my anxieties, all my worries, all my concerns, once and for all, on you, for you care for me affectionately and care about me watchfully. 1 Peter 5:7. I don't worry about anything, but I pray about everything. With a thankful heart, I offer up my prayers and requests to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guards my heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:6-7. I am careful of what I say. If I want to enjoy life and see many happy days, I must keep my tongue from speaking evil and my lips from telling lies. I turn away from evil and do good. I search for peace and work to maintain it. 1 Peter 3:10-11. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. Psalm 19:14. I am a child of God. I am a joint heir. In Christ Jesus, I am a child of God through faith. For I, who was baptized into Christ, have clothed myself with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for we are all one in Christ Jesus. Because I belong to Christ, I am Abraham's seed, and an heir according to the promise. Galatians 3:26-29. Because I am his child, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into my heart, prompting me to call out, Abba, Father. Now I am no longer a slave, but God's own child. And since I am his child, God has made me his heir. Galatians 4:6-7. And he raised me up together with him, and made me sit down together, giving me joint seating with him in the heavenly sphere, by virtue of my being in Christ Jesus, the Messiah, the Anointed One. Ephesians 2:6. I am chosen. I am chosen by God, chosen for the high calling of priestly work, chosen to be a holy people, God's instrument to do his work and speak out for him, to proclaim the praises of him who called me out of darkness into his marvelous light. 1 Peter 2:9-10. You chose me and appointed me to go and bear fruit, and that my fruit should remain, that whatever I ask the Father in Jesus' name, he may give me. John 15:16. I am Christ-like. But I, with an unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, am being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. 2 Corinthians 3:18. People insulted Christ, but he did not insult them in return. Christ suffered, but he did not threaten. He let God, the one who judges rightly, take care of him. 1 Peter 2:21-23. I am clean. I am pure in heart. I walk in the light as he is in the light, having fellowship with others, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses me from all sin. If I say that I have no sin, I deceive myself, and the truth is not in me. If I confess my sins, he is faithful and just to forgive me my sins and to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. 1 John 1:7-9. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Psalm 51:7. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Psalm 51:10. I am comforted. Jesus said, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. John 14:18. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Matthew 5:4. In the multitude of my thoughts within me, thy comforts delight my soul. Psalm 94:19. Now may my Lord Jesus Christ himself and God my Father comfort me and strengthen me in every good thing I do and say. 2 Thessalonians 2:16-17. I am comforting others. God is my merciful Father and the source of all comfort. He comforts me in all my troubles so that I can comfort others. When they are troubled, I will be able to give them the same comfort God has given me. For the more I suffer for Christ, the more God will shower me with his comfort through Christ. 2 Corinthians 1:3-5. Through the patience and comfort of the Scripture, I have hope, and may God grant me to be like-minded toward others. Romans 15:4-5. I am compassionate. I am caring. I am empathetic. When he, Jesus, saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion for them, because they were weary and scattered, like sheep having no shepherd. Matthew 9:36. God loved me and chose me for his own. So then, I must clothe myself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Colossians 3:12. I am confident. For the Lord will be my confidence and will keep my foot from being caught. Proverbs 3:26. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Psalm 118:8. Now all glory to God, who is able, through his mighty power at work within me, to accomplish infinitely more than I might ask or think. Ephesians 3:20. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Philippians 4:13. God began doing a good work in me, and he will continue it until it is finished when Jesus Christ comes again. Philippians 1:6. Now this is the confidence I have in him, that if I ask anything according to his will, he hears me. 1 John 5:14. I am content. I am satisfied. See also, I am fulfilled. I am complete. I enjoy my work and accept my lot in life. It is a gift from God. I don't need to look back with sorrow on my past, for God gives me joy. Ecclesiastes 5:19b and 20. I am sure to do my very best, and therefore will have the personal satisfaction of work well done, and I won't need to compare myself with anyone else. Galatians 6:4. I am courageous. See also, I am strong. I am fearless. I am strong and of good courage. I am not afraid or dismayed, for the Lord my God is with me wherever I go. Joshua 1:9. Hezekiah gave them encouragement, saying, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid nor dismayed before the king of Assyria, nor before all the multitude that is with him, for there are more with us than with him." 2 Chronicles 32:7. I will be of good courage, and he shall strengthen my heart. I hope in the Lord. Psalm 31:24. I am created. I am made in God's image. See also, I am special. I am a child of God. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God he created them, male and female he created them. Genesis 1:27. For you formed my inward parts. You covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Psalm 139:13 through 14. You are my creator. I was in your care even before I was born. Isaiah 44:2a. I am creative. In the beginning, God created. Genesis 1:1. By faith, I understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. Hebrews 11:3. D. I am dead to sin. I am risen. For sin does not have dominion over me. I am not under the law, but I am under grace. Romans 6:14. God is so rich in mercy, and he loved me so much that even though I was dead because of my sins, he gave me life when he raised Christ from the dead. It is only by God's grace that I have been saved. For he raised me from the dead along with Christ and seated me with him in the heavenly realms because I am united with Christ Jesus. Ephesians 2:4 through 6. I am debt-free. See also, I am a tither. I am wealthy. The Lord will open the storehouses of the skies where he keeps the rain, and he will send rain on my land at just the right times. He will make me successful in everything I do. I will have plenty of money to lend to other nations, but I won't need to borrow any myself. Deuteronomy 28:12. I keep out of debt and owe no man anything except to love one another. By loving my neighbor, I fulfill the law. Romans 13:8. I am devoted. I am dedicated. No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. Matthew 6:24. I shall love the Lord my God with all my heart, with all my soul, and with all my strength. Deuteronomy 6:5. In the morning you hear my voice, O Lord. In the morning I prepare a prayer, a sacrifice for you, and watch and wait for you to speak to my heart. Psalm 5:3. I am diligent. I am diligent to present myself approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15. I keep my heart with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Proverbs 4:23. The soul of a lazy man desires and has nothing, but the soul of the diligent shall be made rich. Proverbs 13:4. I am a disciple of Christ. I am living for Christ. Christ gives meaning to my life. Christ is my life. Colossians 3:4a. My old self has been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. So I live in this earthly body by trusting in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Galatians 2:20. But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage, that I may gain Christ. Philippians 3, 7-8. I am a doer of the word. I hear the words of Jesus and put them into practice. My house is built on the rock. Matthew 7, 24-25. I do not grow weary in doing good. 2 Thessalonians 3:13. I don't just listen to God's word. I must do what it says. Otherwise, I am only fooling myself. For if I listen to the word and don't obey, it is like glancing at my face in a mirror. I see myself, walk away, and forget what I look like. But if I look carefully into the perfect law that sets me free, and if I do what it says and don't forget what I heard, then God will bless me for doing it. James 1, 22-25.
Thank you for listening on Second Chance Ministry.